This video tutorial I will explain Spring Boot Thymeleaf example with JDBC. Here you can see ArcDB and it has employee table. We will see how to get these records from employee table and display it in the UI. Here you can see the Spring Boot application with folder structure. Here you can see the pom.xml, and here I have included the dependencies of web, JDBC, MySQL connector, Thymeleaf. Here you can see application.properties file. In this file, I have defined URL of the MySQL database and username and password of the database and the driver class name. Using this information, the Spring Boot application makes connection to the ArcDB and get information from the employee table. Here I have defined the class employee. It has four properties: ID, name, age and salary, which are equivalent to the columns in the employee table. And getter and setter methods for these four properties. Here I have overridden toString method. Here I have defined a class employee repository, which is a repository class. And here I have defined a JDBC template object. When Spring Boot application starts, JDBC template object will be created and injected here, because we have put auto-void annotation, and it has getEmployees method, and in this method I am calling query method of JDBC template object and passing query as select star from employee table and the employee row mapper object. This method returns list of employee objects. Here I have defined a class employee row mapper, which implements row mapper interface and provide implementation of map row method. And in map row method, what we are doing is we are mapping the result set output to the employee object. This method will be called by the query method of JDBC template object. If there are two rows, then this method will be called two times. If there are three rows in employee table, then this method will be called three times. Here I have defined the interface employee service. It has abstract method getEmployees. Here I have defined the class employee service simple, which implements employee service interface and provide implementation of getEmployees method. From this method, we are calling getEmployees method of employee repository object. This class is the service class. Here I have defined a class employee service controller, which is a controller class. And here I have defined getEmployees method. To call this method, we have to send request to this path. And in this method, I am creating a model and view object. Then I am calling getEmployees method of employee service object. This method returns employee list object. That employee list I am setting in the model and view. And view name I am setting as employee details. And this method returns model and view object. The view name is employee details. So the request will forward it to employee details.html. Here you can see. Here we are setting Thymeleaf XML namespace, and from model and view object getting employee list object, and from employee list object getting each employee object and displaying name, age and salary one by one. Here I have defined a class application, which is Spring Boot application, and I am starting Spring Boot application in debug mode. Spring Boot application is started in 8080 port. Next, I am sending the request. Here you can see the two employee details which are there in the employee table. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.